Carter, what do you reckon? Nice bit of glass there.
Yeah, it's a nice ring. Just don't feel the same way about you, Miller. Sorry, mate.
Yeah, it's for sure. Cost me 2 months' wage. It's going to pop the question.
Miller.
I'm sort of thought you'd be happy.
The problem is she's a 6 out of 10, Miller. Right, Sim?
Yeah, 6.
6.5, and I'm being generous there, mate.
You are?
Look, if you're going to tie the knot with someone, you make sure they're a 9 or a 3. A stunner or a complete shitter. You fall in the middle, you're fucked, mate. It's never going to last.
It's bollocks, man.
I'm talking bollocks, yeah? All right, we'll ask the others. Oi, text Clarky. Ask her.
Girlfriend out of 10.
I don't know, I ain't slept with her.
Oi! It's based on looks.
4.5 in a balaclava.
What about you, Lewis?
Don't know her.
What about me then? What would you rate me?
Well, if it was prick size, I'd give you a 2, but since we're talking about faces, I'll give you a 2.
30 seconds!
Average.
Average?
Yeah.
Average.
Not low enough to be grateful to you, not high enough to make you grateful to her. Fucking recipe for disaster.
What about your girl then? What's she score?
We're not married.
The Sweeney shithead, you're nicked.
Yeah, nice work, Regan. Did you really have to destroy the old place in the process?
We got the villains, didn't we?
Well, I've got the headache of explaining why you smashed their heads in and wrecked the whole depot. You know what happened to turn the fears on our back again?
We got the villains, didn't we?
Yeah, shit always rolls downhill, Jack, to me.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry about the miss, but there just happened to be an armed robbery in progress.
Well, listen, if we want to stay operational, we've got to play the game.
It ain't a game when you've got a G3 sticking in the back of your nut. You get to turn the affairs off my fucking case, I'll get your results.
Oi. Remember who runs this unit, Jack, all right?
Yeah, well, you know how we go to work, deal with it.
Yeah, who put it all together in the first place? Who keeps the walls from your door?
Yeah, all right. Well done, kid.
What was the estimate?
Half a mil plus. Cotula, Cougarines and ingots.
Everyone's okay?
Yeah, Miller took one, but he'll live to fight another day.
World's running out of men like you, Jack.
Toast to the new boy. Popped his cherry on the pavement. Raise the fucking glass.
Go in the city!
Yeah. Go on, Penny!
Yeah, yeah, and maybe next time Regan will give you a weapon to hold.
Fuck that.
I became a copper because I'm Irish.
Well, all right, well, I became a copper because I'm black.
What about you, Eggs?
I become a copper because I'm black! You pretty boy.
As pretty as my face is, obviously I don't give a fuck about it that much, as you can see. As far as I'm concerned, there ain't any other job in the world that give me the kind of buzz this one does.
Good boy.
So if this pretty little face of mine has to take a couple more beatings from time to time, so fucking be it, right, Sim?
Got you, boy.
Jakarta's face!
Jakarta's face!
Improvement on when you left the house this morning, darling.
Yeah. Yeah? That's right, is it?
You did. Yeah? You're better looking than this lot.
Okay, yourself?
Well, I'll still in with a shoot.
How's your leg?
It's still giving me egg. Well, yeah, the work went off well.
Yeah, it was just like you said, most fell in our laps.
Word is one of them got a good hiding.
Jules did it. Have you got anything else for me?
Heard about a private bank on Trafalgar Square. Apparently it's being looked at.
Nah, not was that fucking silly anymore.
They say it's a sitting duck.
I'll swing past there tomorrow with George.
How is he?
Hey, George is George, isn't he?
What about you, Jack? You seen anyone special at the moment?
What's the matter with you? You're getting a nosy old bastard. I better get back in there. Make sure Carter's behaving himself.
doing?
Looking for a cigarette.
Here's one. Anyway, you shouldn't be smoking.
Why?
Because you're training for your sports day.
Looks like you should be in training as well.
Saucy little sucker. And don't listen to George, he's a bad influence. You listening, Neil? Your stepdad's a bad seed.
You can talk, can't you, mate? Very romantic toilets.
God, is that a time? We gotta go.
When was you gonna tell me?
We got a flop on that jug that Harry was talking about.
How long you been banging her for, Jack?
When Askins has called for a briefing.
You do know she's married, didn't you? I've known you half my life, and you didn't think to tell me.
What you don't know won't kill you.
Do you know her husband?
Yeah, we're not about the girls, don't we?
I mean, do you know who he is?
I'm sure old Bill.
And he knows about you and her, doesn't
he? What, me banging her? Yeah, he thinks it's a great idea.
Nice bloke, then.
Couldn't roll downhill.
He what?
He's a fucking square.
Right.
You got 30 seconds to tell me how you robbed this bank.
Wouldn't worry about the CCTV, because I don't feed that externally. Getting your hands on the tape shouldn't be a problem. It's a private bank, innit? Private security. And this lot ain't got a license to carry firearms. So what, pistols, cable ties, keep them quiet. Drive out the front 2 to 3 through the door. Neutralize the desk clerk. Dominate the room, disorientate the security. You only need one geezer to hold the floor, while the other two take the lift up to the strong room. But only after collecting all mobiles and depositing them over there. But London Underground situated conveniently close by again. If it all goes tits up out the front, I'd definitely use that as a possible room. As for the loot, I'd sell on any high denomination bills.
Nice to see you learn something in your childhood, George.
Yeah, well, you got to act like a criminal to catch one, didn't you?
Officers, Mr. Bledisloe is here to see you.
Well, I'd much rather talk to you.
Unlikely.
By me?
Regan, flying squadron. Just a routine check. What do you actually do here?
I'm the manager.
No, I mean, what does the bank do?
We're a private clearing bank. We hold large amounts of foreign currency for mostly Middle Eastern clients. We work with Abu Dhabi, Qatar, Dubai.
How large?
On the right day, in the right week, up to 10 million in cash.
You ain't got proper security?
Yes, we do.
No, you ain't. There's shit there set with 9 mil in the back of the canister.
We're not a high street bank.
If you was, there'd be a black here every week.
And who's intending to blag us?
As I said, this is just a routine check.
We tend not to invite police in the bank too often. It can unnerve the staff.
No one invited us.
Well, if there's nothing else.
What a cunt.
I like him.
You would.
He's got panache. Wait, you want me to stick someone on here and watch it?
Yeah, wait for. He likes sitting on his ass doing that one. How's it going, Lewis? How's life at the sharp end? Must be run off your feet catching all them criminals from behind the desk.
I don't need to be on the streets to make arrests, Jack.
Oh.
There's an abundance of criminals amongst the police keeping me busy, you know that.
Tiring work, is it?
Excuse me. Bye for now.
Grow up, Jack. He's not stupid. Don't give him a reason. reason to look up your skirt.
Obviously, you ain't looking up your skirt.
You go left, I'll go right. We wouldn't want anyone to think we're banging each other, would we?
Oi, oi.
Michael.
What you got?
Sign.
Lovely.
Yeah, me and Regan went down to QTZ today.
What's QTZ?
It's a private bank in Trafalgar Square.
I've never heard of it.
Yeah, the reason you've never heard about it before is because it's private. Anyway. Regan wants you to go down there and put the place under observation.
Why me?
Why not you?
Morning, Sweeney. Good job yesterday.
Top draw.
Got a friend with me here today.
I know it's hard enough what we do without being observed as we do it. Nevertheless, I'd like to give a warm welcome to Detective Ivan Lewis from Internals, who I know some of you already know. So no larking about. Give him what he needs, okay?
Thanks, Haskins. Jack, nice to see you again.
How you going?
I'll make this brief. I'm not here looking for scalps. All right, I'm not here to shut you down. I'm just here to observe. Observe how you operate, and if need be, suggest some adjustments to your approach and maybe make some recommendations of how to improve, enhance the unit's success rate.
Success rate? We're just taking out an armed robbery with no civilian casualties. And the week before that, a security van attempt, and all suspects were in custody. Now, have you got a problem with that?
No, Jack.
Good. Oh, and by the way, people who don't know me call me Regan.
The problem is the significant number of legal cases that's mounting against your unit. And these exclusive and, frankly, exorbitant Sweeney offices funded by the taxpayer with...
It's the taxpayer we look after, isn't it?
It causes resentment in other departments, you know. The problem is the methods, tactics you employ. I mean, there's even talk of baseball bats. Pickaxe handles being used to attack suspects. The problem is the collateral damage that's left in your
wake. The problem is people like you that don't let us do our fucking job.
Easy, Jack.
Oh, I'm easy. Fucking easy, yeah.
Carter, you're not supposed to be somewhere.
Combat training, sir.
Give me five, will you?
Don't go too far, George. So what is it then, Lewis? What do you want to see your name up in lights? We've got a medal pinned on you for bringing down the firing squad.
Regan, leave it.
Yeah, all right. Yeah. What are you, like? You want to be the little man who brought down the Sweeney, is that it? Because it's people like you who want to make us obsolete. Because we still do the things that you can only fucking dream of. Take us on. Well, you can have a go. I mean, other people have had a go. You got big bollocks. Have you? You got big fucking nuts. Have you? So look at them. No, I don't think you have. Tell me something, Lewis. Is your problem with the job or with me?
Job. Transpires that some of these ingots were missing from a crime scene. It's also emerged that everybody but the Sweeney was searched.
So what?
Tip. of an already melting iceberg.
I work on the front line, son. Criminals I hunt want me dead. Day in and day out, I'm undermanned, underarmed, and underpaid. I fight crime on the street, not from behind a fucking desk where I could hide. So do something useful, Lewis. Like catch real fucking criminals.
Regan. Everyone's got a weak point.
Help out. Something.
A little unnecessary, wasn't it?
Yeah.
What are you thinking?
Thinking of turning him tonight.
What about this mess? Where'd you start?
I ignored that.
The getaway car already found out by Heathrow. Was torched using phosphorus. Was stolen out of Manchester about a week ago and it was reported and the plates changed.
Jack, the victim was foreign. Natalia Walska. She's working as a temp in a legal firm. She's only in here buying jewellery. Run a check on her. It's nothing out of the ordinary. She's a civilian. Right, that's it.
There I go.
Carl.
Loaded weapon was a 9mm, possibly a Smithy or a high-power Browning. I'm gonna wanna check on spent cases now. I'll get back to you ASAP. But judging by the circumference of the exit wound, I'd say they were using dum-dums.
They
didn't
mess about.
Gov! Found a shape charge. What's left of it?
Now, Ellis, you should be wearing a glove if you touch him.
What a stain to have on your soul, eh? Take someone's life for a couple hundred grand's worth of stones. I mean, you just leave the fucking work and walk, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Looks like they panicked when a hold-up alarm went. Why else would they top her?
Got any ideas?
That was blown in 2000. That was blown the same year. That was blown the following year. And that was blown today. What do you know about the shape charges?
All the same.
Well done, Grasshopper. Now, see him? He gave me his first two sentences when he was just a teenager. He robbed a post office while he was still at school. He's a fucking torpedo.
Francis Allen. 6 years for armed robbery and attempted murder. Back behind bars 1 week after release for another robbery. Gets parole. After that, the trail goes cold.
He progressed to running guns for the provost. And an absolute fucking fortune supplying breakaway paramilitary groups, you know, with small firearms like weaponry. He's got links in Eastern Europe, Chechnya, Russia, Serbia. By all accounts, he went to ground in Montenegro.
So why come back now?
Dunno.
Rob a shitty little low-end jewelers. He's either done all his beans and gone skin, or an opportunity came his way and he simply just couldn't say no.
Well, let's find him and ask him. Check a few trees, see what falls out. And get Simmons, go down out in the garden, see if anyone's trying to fence that bit of Tom.
I'm on it.
Yeah. Oi, I'll pick up the new motor, flop on a few grasses. Someone's got to know he's come back. You look excited?
Yeah, Francis Allen, Gov. Looks like he's come out of retirement.
I need a word.
I'm jogging on.
Regan, I said I need a word. Now.
Yes, Gov.
What's that?
You're playing with a straight bat, aren't you, Jack?
What?
Reassure me that Lewis and his boys have got nothing on you. Nothing that can come back and haunt us.
Nothing, no.
His team are taking it more seriously than I anticipated.
No.
Good. All right, nail your boy for the robbery. I'm sure this will be forgotten about.
Can I ask Bryce then?
Yeah.
Lovely.
What do you know about Alan?
He's a slag.
Close.
Yeah, I gave him his first bit of porridge. It would be a matter of time before I saw his fucking face again. See, cats like Alan, they can't help themselves.
You look excited.
Sorry, it's your tits.
They don't stick out as much as your belly.
What are you saying? I've got to lose a bit of weight?
As long as you don't lose your charm as well.
Well, I suppose I could lose a couple of kilos for you.
I'm touched.
Yeah, I wish I fucking was.
About to be.
Yeah?
Yeah. Here we go. Oh, ice in the rose. How do you want to play this?
Very low key, no trouble.
Members only.
Move.
I said members.
Where the Sweeney's son. Right, get out the fucking worse or break your legs.
Listen up! Right, calm down. We're not here for drugs.
What are you on, Regan?
Oh, Jesus. Ross.
Fucking hell, Regan. Who dug you up, then? What do you want?
Francis Allen. Who is he?
Leave it out. He ain't been about for years. You know that.
Well, maybe he just came back. What do you know about jewel robbery? Innocent girl got one in the back of the nut. Ring any bells? Would you like me to jog your fucking memory?
Leave it out, Regan. You got Nish and you know it. Why don't you take this fucking little drat and piss off?
Well, I'm gonna enjoy this a lot more than you.
Yeah, you think you're gonna enjoy what? What are you
fucking witch? Nobody takes liberties on my patch. If I find out you or any one of these slags know about Alan and his bit of work, I'll hit you so fucking hard, you wish you were already in prison.
fucking will this is.
What are you looking at?
I don't understand. Why would someone tell you where that man is and no one wants to talk to me? What am I, losing my touch here?
What can I say? I just come about it from a different angle than you, that's all. You know, ask them nicely.
Fuck.
Anyway,
bring
my new
up,
little mate. You all right, mate?
Bring me up.
Just on the phone, one sec. He reckons our boy Alan's got a little bolt hole in the countryside. A little anonymous gaff in the middle of nowhere. I reckon we should get down there soon as.
Report to me anything you see. Do not come off of Channel 6. Do not compromise our play.
This is Francis Allen we're dealing with. He's a very capable and dangerous man. He has killed, and he will kill again.
Where the fuck are you?
Been a fucking hour. Do you think he's even in there?
Well, we're no one way or the other, won't we?
He's really got under your skin, isn't he, this one?
I can't have animals running about killing innocent girls and think they can get away with it, George. Not while I'm Sweeney. Oh, fuck me.
Gov, can I ask your advice on something?
Yeah, go and knock yourself out of this.
What would be the best way of asking Lewis out on a date?
Lewis?
Yeah, Nancy. Got a fierce crush on her. I was thinking of asking her to dinner.
I wouldn't bother if I was you, Ellis.
But I fancy her loads. It looks like her marriage is going down the shitter, so.
Listen, that's a work colleague of ours you're talking about there, yeah? Stop being so unprofessional.
Who cares? Not about her.
Ellis Shay.
I just really want to fuck her.
Oh, fucking hell.
And how would you if you ever got the chance, Ellis?
Oh, Jesus. I'd be up on the back of her like a Jack Russell with two Mickeys.
Nito.
Simmons.
Oi, oi, Savaloy.
Where's Wexler?
Well, didn't you send him to stick a bank under observation?
Fuck the bank, I want him here. What about if Alan comes back? I want the whole team here. George, get on the blower.
Yeah, Americana, two sugars. And, organic soya latte for you, Gov.
No.
Soya? Since when did you start drinking fucking soya?
Oh, fuck me.
She got you on the healthy milk now, has she?
Who's that?
No one. Is it that serious? Is it fucking soya serious?
Well, judge for yourself. She's coming to dinner.
I will have a prawn cocktail for starters. Then beef lasagna, some chips, and some garlic bread, please. Eat them for two. Oh, I'll have the deep fried burrito start, and then the, roast loin of pork and a side of chips. Can I get some mayonnaise with that as well?
I will have some white bait, some little, tiny little fishes with little miserable looks on their face.
Yes, darling.
We had in Greece.
Yeah.
I like them. We had them in Greece. I'll have some of them. I also have rigatoni meatballs. Can I have escalope, veal escalope on the side? God, starving. A bit of garlic bread, I think. Yeah. What are you having?
I'll have the pear and walnut salad.
All right. Mm. Cheers, mate.
Did you tell Jack yet, darling?
No.
George has applied for a promotion to DS. They're hearing it, too.
Marvellous. How's Neil done at school, mate?
Piss off, Jack. You never asked about him before. I don't think you care, mate.
Just inquiring.
So George tells me you're married, Nancy. Yes. But Jack's a better fuck.
That's a good one.
I'm only joking, just that, you know, I'm in the final stages of a marriage. The only thing keeping us together is a roof over our heads, so... of you and me getting on tonight,
so. I'm trying here, I'm fucking trying.
You might lose it before you get me into bed.
I've got more chance of losing this time. If you was looking at what I was looking at, you know why I was so excited.
Alan.
Yeah, he pulled up with a Range Rover and went in with a suitcase.
Could be the jewels.
Positive ID.
Guess who just woke up?
We've got to fucking go now, Carla.
Wait.
Listen, Jack, we're going to miss the boat on this one if we don't go now.
Hold up.
What's the business?
Yeah.
Nobody move. Unidentified vehicle approaching.
Roger that. We're in position. We're ready to move.
That's got to be them, innit?
It's the rest of the firm. Moving to position.
Remember. It's my dumbass about, so it might have fast. Dominate and pacify.
I've got a fucking eye on them.
Simmons with me, Ellis along the wall. Come on. Put your trousers on your knees.
Right,
liven you right up. You're gonna get plenty of porridge, son.
Keep fucking moving.
Fucking in room, that's right.
A cigarette.
I want fucking nothing from you, man.
Look, Freddie, I'm sure your whole life you've been told not to talk to the police. You live by a code. Honor amongst thieves and all that. Believe it or not, I respect that. But you see, your code's already been broken. Because armed robbery is one thing, and murder is another.
You know, I ain't got a clue what you're talking about. I was at a barbecue.
Bang!
I wonder how it'd really feel to be shot in the head, point blank. 1 minute, you're going about your business, buying a present for a friend. The next,
bang!
Nothing. Gone. A full stop on an ordinary life.
Bit funny, isn't it? You all meeting around Allen's this morning?
I told you. I was at a barbecue gather.
Bollocks.
Why don't you check the shopping bags? You think I carry fucking pork chops around with me for the fun of it?
Listen to me. I went round there for a barbecue.
Bollocks. You went round Allen's house for your lick of the lolly.
I got a bag full of pepper steaks and sausages out there. Go and have a look.
What the fuck happened to you, Allen? I used to think you was a bit of a player a few years ago. Now, you're turning over to Bob Jewelry Shops. And killing punters.
You're the trigger man, then?
No comment.
You like killing innocent women. She's only buying a present for a fucking friendly scum. 23 years old.
Shape charge like that is only available from early industrial builders merchants. Owen, you need a ticket for that. It's a specialist skill set. Only someone with a criminal or military history would be capable. I knew you weren't in the army, was you? Because I stuck you in a fucking shovel.
Come
here.
Come here.
You see, Mr. Gold's been murdered.
I'm the kind of person. I want to see those responsible brought to justice, but you! You're the kind of person. If you had any information on someone like that, you keep it to yourself.
May I?
Knock yourself out.
Do you know what that is? It's a watch mark. Tan line. Know why? Because I've been in the sun.
So?
So you can sit there and say anything you want about me and that bit of work. You can tell me that's my MO. Now it could have only come from me. Fingerprints. DNA. Shape charge.
Yeah.
There is one fact you're overlooking, Regan.
Oh, what's that?
One piece of undeniable evidence that any jury in the land would chuck out of court.
Go on.
That I was on my yacht. Lying in the sun.
You're gonna have to do better than that, son.
Why don't you ask your sidekick to bring my mobile phone in here? Please.
George, bring this Slegs mobile in, will you? I know it's you.
When I put you away from me for so long, next time you come out, you'll be walking on fucking sticks.
Maybe.
Go on, dig an hole for yourself. The coast of Montenegro. The time and dates at the top of the screen. But you saw that, didn't you, Regan?
Yeah.
Regan, quick word.
I'll be right there, Gov. Keep your eye on him.
Seem like a smart man, Francis. You shouldn't underestimate me. I ain't no one psychic.
What you got? Electronic strip on his passport confirms he was out of the country the time of the robbery. He re-entered the night Wexstrew saw him with his suitcase. I think you got the wrong man. Anyone could have carried his passport. You know what he's capable of. It's a move, Gov.
Doesn't look like a move from here. And you know we only have him in custody for 24 hours.
I just need one more little piece of evidence to tie him to the crime.
Get it quickly, Regan. You don't charge him by 10 a.m. tomorrow. He's a free man. And you're sitting in a pile of shit.
Sick of sneaking about in the shadows. I want you to leave him. I want you to live with me.
What, here in a Holiday Inn? It's not that easy.
I'll get you a gaff. Oh, man. We can set up shop together, you and me. I mean, we're good together. You make me feel hungry. Think about it.
Come get back into bed, Jack. I'm stressed.
Nah. I've got his slag in a cell. I know he's fucking playing me. I just can't link him with a crime, but I know he done it.
I know, Jack.
I just want to put him away.
I know, Jack.
I need to fucking put him away.
I know, Jack.
The Pope. What do you think it is?
What's wrong with you? Don't you sleep?
Put your clothes on, George. Three armed males entered the premises. There's one driver outside, one holds the door. Two clear the premises and work the counters. Shake charge. Close the safe. Moving out in another 2 minutes. One victim. Innocent girl is just buying a fucking present. I mean, what's that all about? Joanna Green's worth of stones and Tom gone. And what we got?
We've got Alan.
Yeah, only for a couple of hours. Play it
with it, Heather.
Wait, wait, I've gone back too far.
Fuck it, leave it there, play. So we come in and clear the place. Shot charged them, fucking. Okay. Fucking glasses.
Has anyone checked her phone, Rick, to find out who she's talking to?
Yeah, Simmons is on it.
It's funny how a few seconds after she hangs up, the place gets knocked over. Why turn back? They got what they came for.
You didn't need the killer. He's done it for another reason. He's killed her for another reason.
It wasn't just a robbery.
It was an execution. Gov?
Yeah?
Alan killed the girl to cover something up. It wasn't just a robbery. Look at the CCTV. He murdered her for another reason. We've run a check on the mobile phone. She's got one number in her address book. So pay as you go.
Let me guess, it's disconnected.
Yeah. So what, he dead?
Where are you?
We're on our way to the victim's house now.
You got 2 hours, Regan. After that, he's gone. And Lewis has got all he needs to put the bite on you.
I'm Officer Carter from the Flying Squad. We're investigating the murder of Natalia Wolskat. We believe she was renting a room here, is that correct?
I've already spoken to the police.
Not to us, you haven't.
It's still early in the morning.
So what?
Have you seen this man?
No. You've got police ID. She came over from Serbia several years ago.
She's working as a temp, right?
Who's that, family?
Look, quite a few of them. They came over here once.
Did they? Boyfriend?
Brother.
George. So you look at this, I ain't got any pins.
Who's the man in the picture?
He came to the house recently.
How recently?
Weeks.
What's his name? Think. What's his name?
I don't know.
Free to go.
What are you talking about?
Leave it, George. Please.
Law states you've still got 15 minutes to question me. Don't you want to use it?
Please.
can only apologize.
The ramifications of your careless actions are going to have severe repercussions, Regan.
Are they? Simmons. Show this dog off the premises.
I think I've found your weak point.
No. You found my glasses.
It's where I found them that matters.
Don't push me, Lewis. I've not need a throat to get my hands around.
You threatening me, Regan?
No, I'm not threatening you.
Under a lot of pressure.
It's about to get a lot worse.
Well, I apologize on his behalf.
Heard you applied for promotion, Carter.
Yeah?
You've got an impeccable record, you know that? Misdirected adolescent turns his back on crime after a family tragedy. Accelerates through basic at Hendon with honors. A guy like you could be running the Sweeney in a few years.
Making trouble, you slag.
Right. This is our man, making trouble. He's a Serb, ex-paramilitary. Wanted for robbery across Switzerland, Italy and France. Got an art of killing witnesses. We believe he killed the girl to cover his tracks. What she saw and what she heard, we still don't know, but we will find out. Have you got that?
Yes, sir.
Good.
Mate, you look like shit. You should go home and get some sleep.
Why didn't I see it coming, George? Am I fucking losing it or what?
Look, we all thought it was Alan. Don't worry about it. Go and get some rest. You're no good to us when you're
Garth, that private bank on Trafalgar Square that you pulled Wextrew off of? Well, a member of staff has just triggered a hold-up alarm.
It's Trebell.
Right, we'll run down in the compound under a minute. Check your weapons, your vests. Armed robbery in progress.
Do not inform any other unit. I don't want to spook him. With me. Armed robbery.
Is it Trafalgar Square?
Yeah.
Same bank Natalia Walscat worked at up until 2 weeks ago.
Gov. I fucked up. You were right. Alan had nothing to do with it.
The man we're after is making trouble, and there's a robbery in progress at a
private bank we pulled away from.
Regan, stand down. That's an order.
We're less than 3 minutes away.
I'm ordering you to stand down, Regan. You hear me? Stay away.
Lewis made an official complaint about you. Don't give him an opportunity to close us down. You hear me, Regan? Stand down.
I thought about what you said. I'll do it. I'll come with you.
Thank you.
Ainsley.
Evaded capture despite a dramatic pursuit by police, although it is thought one of the men suffered a serious gunshot wound to the neck. Police also want to question Serbian national Makin Trabolt in connection with the robbery, as well as the murder of Natalia Walskat, who was killed earlier this week in another armed raid.
Zora Suleiman reporting from Trafalgar Square.
Janice?
Sorry for your loss. I'm sorry.
I'm gonna destroy you, Regan. I'm gonna make sure you never work in the police force again. I'm freezing your bank accounts. I'm freezing your assets, your home, your whole life. I hold you alone responsible for what happened. For my wife. You're a dinosaur. You're extinct. And there's no place for a man like you in our community. Your unit suspended. Pending further investigation, if you approach any witnesses or suspects associated with this case, I'll have you arrested and remanded immediately. I'm assigning a team to monitor you around the clock, so you think about making a move? You think again. Because I'm gonna be there. I want your gun and your badge until the investigation's over, your mobile phone as well. If I didn't believe in the law, right? The next time I see you, I won't show the same restraint.
What are you doing here? I thought you was in hospital.
Well, you thought wrong. You coming? Come on, let's go.
Go where?
To a boat.
The unit's been suspended, you know that?
So, just me and you then?
No. Askins has ordered me to stay away.
Did he?
I can't risk my job. I can't. Not with Megan the way she is, you know I can't.
Lose your job?
Yeah.
You wouldn't have a fucking job if it weren't for me. You'd still be a two-bob thief on the estate sticking brown up yourself.
Well, fucking hard to be in this squad. You may show me the fucking door, but I'm not one to walk through it. You think I ain't hurting? You think I ain't fucking hurting? I lost a valuable fucking member of my team today. It don't matter how I feel, does it? No, because I want the one who's fucking up. Why don't you protect her, Jack? She should have been protected.
Stuck in the car. I couldn't move. I couldn't help her. What could I fucking do? I can't live like this. I just need your help. I'm on the fucking ropes here.
I'm being watched.
Where?
On the roadside.
Hello, son. Come here. Got a mobile on you?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, get your mobile and try to smudge me. Go on.
What happened to your face?
Give that to Harry. Tell him to meet me in the crow's nest. I want a gun and a badge. I've never asked you for anything, George.
Bad business, this.
They played me, Harry. Made me look fucking ordinary.
Well, there's nothing ordinary about you, pal.
Well, it all goes so fucking wrong.
Well, you didn't, but they didn't either.
Who told you about the bank?
A friend of a friend. Some Eastern Bloc trigger man with loose limbs. More chance of finding a better class in Deptford.
Very good. You got the yoga.
This is all up there. Laid me paws on.
Yeah. I stuck a 9mm in one of them. You ain't gonna get far with an untreated gunshot wound. I need you to do me a favour, Harry. I need to check hospitals like Booba, clinics, vets, you know, quacks, that sort of thing.
Find them, Jack.
Yeah, I will.
people. I don't care. I don't talk to the police.
I ain't the fucking police no more. Now who's making trouble? What's his connection to Alan?
I told you in the cells. I went to Alan's for a barbecue.
Wrong fucking answer.
No, no, don't! Alan paid me. He paid me.
For what?
To take his passport out of the country.
Where is he now?
I don't know.
I said...
God! Please.
Where the fuck is he now?
To search you. Now into your pockets.
Yeah, that's the language you understand, isn't it? I'm arresting you on suspicion of witness intimidation. You have the
You're
right to remain.
Fucking me.
You bastard. Cuff him.
Promotion you applied for?
Not in the market no more.
You want to waste your time with false loyalties? Or be of real value to your community? Redundant camaraderie? Or fulfilled potential? It's a simple choice, Carter. It's my direct line on my mobile. You call me when you're ready to become the man you're capable of being.
People look up to you. But in here, you're my most hated prisoner. You make sex cases look popular. Truth is, you should be on the roll, in seg. Not a normal courtyard exercise for your own safety. But we haven't got the space. So you'll have to stay on the open wing till we can transfer you.
All right, open up.
Thank you.
Here he is.
How's the leg, Harry?
It still bloody hurts. Tell my friend here what you know.
Got a call this afternoon asking if I could treat a gunshot wound for cash.
Do you know where he is?
I should do. I operated on him an hour ago. Pulled this from his collarbone.
What's his condition?
Shot.
Regan did it.
There's a taxicab office on the next street along. But in the back, they sell crack and heroin. He's recuperating in the apartment. I wouldn't go in there blazing. He's not alone.
Bernard.
Take care.
Yes, I'm with a dozen or so friends, and we need to get into Soho. Could you tell me how many drivers you have at base at the moment?
Neil? It's Uncle Jack. Listen, I need to speak to Daddy, kid.
He's gone, Uncle Jack.
Where is he?
I don't know.
Listen, Neil, I've got to talk to him. Get a message to him for me. It's very important.
Alan never left the country. Funny place to bump into each other. Gotta laugh, eh?
Yeah.
Busy in your mind. Nice little diversion you set up here. And you saw yours onto the bank, very clever. Almost pulled it off as well. There's one thing you didn't take into account. Me, you cunt. Now I'm gonna ask you a question. You answer it if you wanna live. Where's Chabot going?
About with you, mate.
Your friend of mine is over there on your wall. He's in a spot of bother and I ain't about to let him down, so you better tell me what the fuck I want to know or I will shoot you.
Answer me! Where's he fucking going?
Gucci! In English, motherfucker, I don't speak your language.
Home.
How's he getting there?
Boat.
What boat? Where?
Gravesend. Pegasus.
Gravesend? The Pegasus. See, that wasn't too difficult, was it? This is for Nancy.
Drop the gun! Drop the gun! Calm down, I'm pleased.
Don't talk, just drop the gun!
I'm Officer George Carter from the Flying Squad.
Keep your hands behind your head!
Go in my pocket and you will find my badge.
How are your weapons, boys?
Got a report that an IC-1 was seen assembling a firearm in a nearby vehicle. Gotta say, I'm disappointed it was you, Carter.
Yeah, well, it weren't gonna be Regan, was it? There's your man. You can't shut up shop now. I told you I know where Travolta is, I know where he's going. I just annihilated four geezers to get you that information. And you don't even want to hear it.
Take it easy, Carter. I just got you off the hook and it won't happen again. I'm all out of favours. You can take all your intelligence down to the NCI when they interview you.
Askins, come on! You're just gonna leave Jack in prison, locked up like a criminal. What about the Sweeney? What about Regan? Come on.
You're starting to sound a lot like him, and you're better than that. You got a big future ahead of you if you can just keep your bloody head down.
Don't patronize me.
I'm not. Look at the way he's ended up. Is that what you want? To become like Regan?
You know fuck all about what I want, what's best for my future. I'm my own man. I didn't join police to be some constable out on the beat or to sit behind a desk. I became police to be in a Sweeney. So if there's no Sweeney, there is no Officer George Carter.
Oi, come here, Carter. Carter! I'm talking to you.
What's Pegasus?
It's the name of Alan's boat, oi.
You got a friend.
Oi, oi.
How the fuck did you manage that?
Couldn't believe it, they had fucking pictures. Hundreds of pictures of us. They've been watching us the whole fucking time.
We walked right into this. Trebolt blew the safe with the jewelers to make it look like Alan because he knew we'd go after him. That's why it was so easy to find him. We had him cuffed in a cell and we let him walk. I knew Francis Allen was involved. We had him on a fucking plate.
So that's this.
I'm listening.
The Pegasus has already entered British waters. Repeat, Alan's boat is already here. And Jack? I'm sorry.
Let's have it.
I knew you'd take a bait rig. All I had to do was dangle the carrot. Oh, fucking. Mark! You're such an easy target.
I blew your fucking brains out.
Hey, best be over, Sanyaka.
Thank you.
Thank you.